And I'm not worried if it gets onto my lids because I'll be using a darker color later on my lids, which will conceal this color. Next, I'm going to be taking a darker brown color called Fulani with a fluffy brush. I'm going to saturate my entire eyelids and I'm going to keep layering till I'm happy with the darkness on my lids. It should be pretty fairly dark, so you can use your finger to do this or wet a fluffy brush and apply the shadows directly with the brush as well, but keep applying it till you get a dark brown shade on your lids. Next, I'm taking this beautiful bronzy gold shimmer called Casablanca and I'm going to be using it in the inner corner and I will bring it all the way to 1/3 of my lid. To give the center of my eyelids a pop and make it look larger, I'm going to be using the color Dahia, again applying it with my finger right in the center of my lid. And to define the outer corner further, but with a shimmer, I'm going to be using this dark brown shimmer. It's almost a rosewood color with a lot of glitter in it. And this is from my Smashbox Full Exposure palette. So I'm going to be using that in the outer corners and blending it in with the other colors with my finger again. If you observe Deepika's face, it was very glowy and very dewy, almost like a summery shine with a beautiful smoky eye. So to get that beautiful base on the face, I'm going to first prime my face with the retinol serum. It always gives a very smooth finish and a beautiful glow onto any foundation that goes over it. And because we're going for that dewy look, I'm using the Fit Me by Maybelline foundation. This is the Dewy Plus Smooth in the color Natural Beige. I'm going to apply this all over my face with a beauty sponge. Using the Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser from Maybelline, I'm going to go ahead and conceal my dark circles as well as highlight just my T-zone with it. To stop the concealer from creasing, I'm going to use just a tiny amount of powder just under my eyes. This is from Artistry, it's their Exact Fit Setting Powder. Using the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contour Stick, I'm going to go ahead and contour my face. This is mostly going to be a cream contour kind of a look because again, it's a dewy look. I don't want to use too many powders on my face. To add a little bit more dimension to my contouring, I'm going to be using just a tiny amount of Master Conceal from Maybelline and apply it right under my cheekbones. And then to bring all the colors together and set my face, I'm going to use just a tiny amount of pressed powder. This is from Smashbox. Just remember, again, we are going for that dewy look. So just a tiny amount and I'm going to dust it all over my face just to bring everything together. To add a pinch of that sun-kissed glow, I'm going to be using the Butter Bronzer from Physicians Formula. Next, I'm adding a tiny amount of blush. This is So Shy from Sephora. And finally, to achieve that glow, I'm going to be using two different illuminators on my face. First, I'm going to be using this Sigma Nightlife Liquid Illuminator. I'm going to be applying it right on the highest point of my cheekbones. And then I'm going to be using the Physicians Formula Glow Pearls on the highest point of my cheekbones, on my forehead, on the bridge and tip of my nose, on my cupid's bow, as well as my chin. Moving back to my eyes to finish it up, I'm going to first use the color Burkina again in my lower lash line and I'm going to smoke it out. Next, I'm using this Jordana black eye pencil in my waterline, and then I'm going to set it using a black eyeshadow. Next, I'm going to be applying some mascara and some lashes. My mascara is from Wet n Wild. It's their Lash Renegade. And for my lashes, I'm using the Lava Lashes in Rebel. To hide the lash band, I'm going to be using the Sigma eyeliner. This is in black, and I'm going to go over just one time over the lash band. Using the Mineral Glow Pearls just one more time, I'm going to highlight my inner corners as well as my brow bones. To achieve the beautiful nude color lips, I'm going to be using the Rimmel Kate Nude Collection Lipstick in the shade 46. And finally, I'm finishing up my eyes by applying mascara to my lower lashes. Moving on to my hair, first I'm going to side part my hair because she has a side partition. And mind you, for this hair, it's such a pretty, such a simple hairstyle. You don't even need any tools. You can just use your fingers to do this hair. But today I'm going to be using a teasing brush to tease my hair just to give it that extra volume. And to get that perfect messy ponytail, I'm going to be tying my hair into two ponytails and then I will join them together. So to do this, first I'm going to take all the hair from the sides just above my ear and I'm going to tie my first ponytail. And with the remaining hair, I'm going to tie my second ponytail. And then I'm going to use an elastic or a rubber band to tie them together. Once you've done this part, make sure you start pulling some hair out just to give it some extra volume and oomph in the back. To hide the elastic bands, I'm going to take a tiny section of hair from my ponytail and I'm going to go around the rubber bands and then I'm going to pin it up with a bobby pin. We're not trying to achieve a very clean, neat, back tight ponytail here. We want it to be a little bit messy. To make it voluminous, clean and messy at the same time, use some hairspray. Pull your hair further to give it that extra volume and then use the back of a rag tail comb to comb back your hair. Never use a clean brush or a comb. That's when you start getting that clean back combed hair. You don't want that. To get that messy hair, use the back of a rag tail comb or just your fingers. And finally, of course, I'm accessorizing with a similar earring that she has from Sabyasakshi. I made my earrings myself and that tutorial again is coming on Wednesday. And here is the final look, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you know what to do. Please give me that big fat thumbs up and let me know your thoughts by commenting below about what you thought of this look. And if you have any other recreations in mind, do let me know as well. Again, I'll see you on Wednesday and I will show you how to make these earrings. Until then, you take care. Bye-bye. I'm not the one who's running out of time.